Mark Richt, consistent winner, but a champion. Mark Rogers TV, the voice of college football, bringing you predictions for all the Power 5 teams. We have landed at our final stop in the ACC, and it's with the Coastal Division champions, the Miami Hurricanes. Mark Richt, we know the track record at Georgia. Consistent winner, one of the best winning percentages in college football during his 15 years. Won the SEC three times. Got within a national championship game appearance a few times, but could not complete the deal. At Miami, you win championships. That's the legacy. That's not the recent past, but that's the legacy in the 80s, 90s, and into 2000s with that last title in 01. So Mark Richt was brought here to win national titles. That starts with the ACC and knocking off, of course, Florida State and Clemson. All right, everything points up. So he's done a great job to start. 9-4 the first year, improved to 10-3, got that Coastal Division championship and the monkey off the back in regards to getting to the ACC title game. Now, what is he going to do? The recruiting has been outstanding. This team is now stacked at all the skill position players, both offensively and on all three levels of the defense. It's quarterback and offensive line. Those are the questions. All right, that brings us to that guy, Malik Rozier. 54% passer. That went down because of his final four games that were generally awful. He did throw for over 3,000 yards, 26 touchdowns, and 14 picks. Hot and cold, he can make the throws. He's got the arm, but he goes into funks, and it gets mighty ugly. All right, Nikosi Perry and Jaren Williams evidently don't grasp the offense because all the indications are that these guys should be better than Malik Rozier, that they have more talent, they're more natural throwers, that they have dynamic playmaking ability, but they have not won the job. Travis Homer has won the job. He ran for almost 1,000 yards last year and 8 touchdowns. He also caught 18 passes out of the backfield. DJ Dallas is a guy that was on a roll against Wisconsin in the Orange Bowl and led a touchdown drive in which he was featured, and then they got away from him when they had the Badgers on their heels. Regardless, 217 yards and 3 touchdowns for DJ Dallas last year, but is he going to get the same amount of carries? But because here comes the five-star stud, the number one rated running back in the country coming out of high school, Lorenzo Lingard. A wide receiver, we could talk about a zillion guys. We will mention Amon Richards, of course, who was a freshman All-American with almost 50 catches the previous season. He was hobbled by an ankle and only caught 18 passes and 3 scores last year. Jeff Thomas is a burner, classic burner. A mismatch out there on an island, 17 receptions, 2 touchdowns. Then the number 3 job is all over the place. You've got all sorts of candidates with the spring game MVP, Brian Hightower, Mike Harley, who caught 9 passes last year, Lawrence Cager caught 16 and 3 scores, and then, of course, Daryl Langham, who didn't wow anyone on the stat sheet, but he caught 2 of the more important passes of the season, the fourth down conversion to beat Georgia Tech and the game winner on the final drive against Florida State. All right, a couple 4-star tight ends will be in the mix as well. The offensive line is the key to the team. And the offensive line has not been good. It's not been awful. It's getting better. Here are the starters. Navon Donaldson at guard. Tyree St. Louis at tackle. You've got Tyler Gauthier at center. Those are the 3 starters coming back. They have 47 combined starts. Let's get to the defense. It was really good most of 2017. The defensive line is a key this year because they lose some key contributors, especially the guy that I just thought was probably the defensive MVP of the ACC last year, and R.J. McIntosh. 4 of the top 6 defensive linemen, all told, are gone from this team, and they made it all happen last year. Of course, you got to have the defensive line play to free up everybody else and get the pass rush that you need for the DBs to not stay back there running and chasing guys down forever. Defensive end Joe Jackson's back, 10.5 tackles for loss and 6.5 sacks, and also Demetrius Jackson. Gerald Willis is on campus, and he is ready to explode. Everybody is impressed with this guy's athleticism, and he is a monster, ready to explode on campus. Linebackers, some of the best in the nation. Shaq Quarterman, 83 tackles. Zach McCloud with 48. Michael Pinckney with 68 and 11 tackles for loss. Jaquan Johnson is a stud. He's a star in college football. 96 tackles and a 4-interception season in 2017. So is cornerback Michael Jackson. He had 4 picks last year. Trajan Bandy, the lesser of the two, but still a really quality player, a bit undersized, but he had a pick 6 included in 2017. The pass defense inexplicably fell apart during the final 4 games of last year, giving up 70% completion percentage and a 162 passer rating despite the defensive line play. A great set of linebackers that would seem to cover the intermediate routes and clog up the backs in the backfield coming out for the swing passes and shut that down. And then the secondary's really good, but they just didn't have it the final 4 games. Place kicker Michael Badgley is gone. He will need to be replaced, of course. And let's check out Miami's schedule. They've got 2 difficult non-conference games. They were tested by Toledo last year. They were up to the challenge in the second half at home. This time they go to Toledo. And, of course, they've got the marquee first game matchup at Cowboys Stadium, AT&T Stadium, against LSU. In the Atlantic Division, the 2 crossover games this year, of course, Florida State is always the case. This year they've got a trip to Boston College on a Friday night. Tricky game for the Canes. So here's the outlook for Miami. They win the non-conference schedule. They beat LSU on opening night. They beat Toledo. They're 4-0 non-conference. In the ACC, they lose 2 games. They're expected to win them all based on win probability. It would be likely for them to lose 1 game, but I expect them to lose 2 games non-conference or in the ACC. Most likely, those are going to be Florida State and at BC, possibly at Virginia Tech. So between those 3 games, Virginia Tech, Boston College, Florida State, Miami loses 2. They go 10-2. That leaves them at 6-2 in the ACC, but most importantly, most likely they win the ACC Coastal based on my other projections. So they're the Coastal Division champions, but with 2 losses, do they have a chance at the playoff? Well, if they face a top 5 Clemson team and win, they're on the bubble for a national championship bid. That's my take on Miami football, of course. Leave your predictions down in the comments section, and we will love to read those on the Canes in 2018. Right here on Mark Rogers TV, the voice of college football. And, of course, subscribe to our newsletter. Just leave your email at my email address, markrogerstv@gmail.com. Leave your email there to get set for the newsletter that will be released every Monday during the college football season.